Oh, the show is finally starting to pick up. What's going on, YouTube? Welcome to WeSibs West Coast, East Coast Siblings, where we talk about your favorite movies and TV shows. Today, we are talking episode 6 of The Walking Dead World Beyond. So we're going to talk about our review, reaction, recap, biggest takeaways from the episode, all rolled into one video. So sit back, relax, grab a snack, and let's dive into it. Also, guys, stay tuned until the end to see my predictions for the next episode based off the teaser trailer. Also, hit the like button, subscribe, and click the bell. Let's get into it. So right off the bat, I'm really excited with the direction this show seems to be going now. I was so tired of them, the group just being stuck in one place trying to fix a problem. Last week, they were trying to make a boat. The week before, they were stuck in a high school. Nothing in the story was actually directly tied to where they were. There was no kind of mission that had them moving around. It was just, let's fix this one problem and have all these conversations. In an effort to build character. And okay, you know, episodes like that have their place. Some things you just need to explain. But I'm finding that I'm liking the group dynamic as a whole now that I see them kind of problem solving together and living life together as opposed to just having those conversations. How do you say it? Talk is cheap. And so while I'm still not sure how I feel about each character individually, I'm starting to like the dynamic they have. There's a lot of diversity just in the personality types and the skill sets that I think makes them a pretty dynamic and even potent group, especially with the addition of the two characters that we'll get to a little bit later on in the show. All right, so obviously the biggest thing about this episode is meeting Percy and Tony and all the shenanigans that go down. But a couple things I want to get to before we start. And first of all, that is Iris's extreme lack of judgment. Now, Hope and Iris have had problems making decisions time and time again, with Hope in that episode where they were at the bog, the Blaze of Gory, and she leaves in the middle of the night to go enact a plan that they had all agreed they weren't going to do. That obviously backfires. So Iris had done this before when they just left the campus colony, and she was trying to kill that walker, and that just backfired when everybody's like, hey, stop. She didn't do it. Now she's back at it again in this episode, where after promising Felix that she wasn't going to run after them, she does exactly that, and of course, it backfires, and she gets herself into a dumpster with some walkers. But we'll get to that part of the story-wise, and I'll react to that. But another thing I want to talk about is, again, Hope and Elton. They're on a collision course, basically. Hope killed Elton's mom. She seems to be trying to pay for it in all these little ways without actually telling Elton what she did. She's like, oh, I'll help you finish your book and all this stuff. Elton seems to think that it's a little weird, maybe, but he's not fully catching on to it, as I'm sure he that would be the furthest thing from his mind, that, hey, this girl who's, you know, we're building a friendship or whatever, she probably killed my mom. Hope is definitely feeling guilty, so this is a slow burn. We're just going to have to wait and see. We know it's going to weigh too heavy on her. First of all, they wouldn't have brought it up if it wasn't going to continue to weigh on her until she finally lets him know. And then who knows what the reaction will be. I've been gauging the audience the last couple weeks, so let me know in the comments down below how you think the aftermath of that is going to work out. One more thing I want to get into before we dive into the main event of this episode, and that is the love triangle that they are creating between Iris, Silas, and Percy. Percy is the new guy. Yeah, Silas does not like this Percy kid, and you can tell really quickly why. He almost immediately gets all of Iris's attention from the second that he shows up in the episode. She's sitting by him in the fire and just so fascinated by the stories he's telling. She gives him the benefit of the doubt when Hope calls him out on a lie that he told about the truck, and she's like, oh, well, you know, is this true? Like, I don't know why she had so much loyalty to him from the beginning, but they were definitely trying to fast track a seemingly loving relationship between him, and so that might cause some conflict between Silas and Percy down the road. Okay, now let's get into it. So this episode deals with Percy, the character who came and tried to beat them all with a stick. He's more of a storyteller. We find out that he and Tony are kind of con men. They do shows and stuff, and that's how they barter. And they say, you know, it's better to do this than to actually rob and kill and do all that stuff. It's just his business. And Iris seemed to take issue with that, but I was like, Iris was like, you deserve a medal or something. I'm like, maybe they do. That's a pretty ingenious way, like, to actually start paying for things, if not with money, by some way, shape, or form. It actually reminded me of a scene in The Walking Dead, the original series, where they had gotten everybody together to watch a movie. And it was like, it was a weird thing because season after season, we were so used to the old world being gone. And just for them to be able to bring back a little bit of the old world was kind of cool. And it was, this scene was kind of reminiscent of that. So Percy tells them there's a truck, and Iris immediately wants to go after it. Now, it's not a very wise decision, and I feel like Felix should have just nipped it in the bud, but Iris was obviously making this decision because she was maybe a little smitten by Percy and wanted to help him out. But that obviously backfired, as Percy and Tony had planned to scam them and take all of their stuff. Oh, by the way, if I haven't introduced, Tony is the guy who raised Percy since his mother either left or passed away. I'm not sure. Correct me down in the comments down below. Yeah, so during this whole scam, Iris decides to break her promise to Felix. Now, in real life, being realistic, this group, these two, Hope and Iris, would definitely have gotten them all killed at this point. Several times they just go back on their word or do sneaky things after telling people something else. You know, Iris seems to have this thing where she's like, I have to prove this to myself that I don't need saving. Like, are you serious? Yes, you need to be saved. That's why you're in a group. You've been out here in the wilderness for what? A couple days, maybe a week or so, a little bit more than a week, and all of a sudden you feel like you need to be independent this quickly. It just doesn't make any sense, and somebody needs to check her and Hope on it before, like I said, they get themselves and their group killed. But for this episode, Iris and her lack of judgment did do something positive, at least one thing, and that is she decided to go back for Percy when she thought he had died, and that convinced him to go back and save them, and they definitely needed it, as Iris got herself stuck in a dumpster and walkers were coming. It was a bad situation. So all in all, I think the group turned out pretty well. They have transportation, they picked up two extra people with some interesting skill sets. It seems Tony is aware of some things that he wants to get or some places he wants to go, and he talks to Felix about the Civic Republic badge that he has on his leather jacket, and he seems to think that that's going to get him out of some tight situations if they run into the Civic Republic. Here's the thing, as far as we know in the show, Felix doesn't work for the Civic Republic. He knows nothing of their protocol. If they run into them, why wouldn't they just think that this dude Felix just killed a Civic Republic soldier or someone and took their jacket? Now, you would hope that these people would remember that they had dealings with Campus Colony. But they killed everyone in Campus Colony, and these people are survivors. So I talked a couple weeks ago about how this group was going to find out that the Campus Colony was done, that it was destroyed. This may be an avenue to that outcome, with the Civic Republic attacking the group because they're survivors from Campus Colony that they don't want around. So with that, now let's get into next week's teaser, and I'll talk a little bit about my thoughts for that. Oh, this teaser frustrates me. I hope that it's not true. Starting with Huck. She's just back. She left for 2 days. She looks like she found a pair of boots. Like, what was the point of that? I thought there'd be some kind of rescue mission. Maybe she'd get captured or something by Civic Republic. They'd have to chase her. Nope, she's just back. I don't know why they took her out of the last episode. Maybe there were some constraints or whatever. But guys, this teaser is frustrating me because once again, it seems like they are going to be stuck in one location. It looks like some sort of research facility that they get to. And it just looks like another let's explore it like they did with the high school. Talking, having some conversations for character development. It's like, no, let's see the journey. It also seems that there's somebody hidden away in there. Maybe he's got a group. It doesn't look like he does. He doesn't look very well taken care of. And he ends up taking Hope hostage. Now, if I were to make one quick prediction, I would say that Elton in some way, shape, or form ends up saving Hope. And that's going to be just that last straw that breaks the camel's back. She's going to be like, you saved my life. I've got to tell you what I did. So a little drama brewing there. I really, really don't want them going back in that direction. But with this episode 6 being pretty good, I have some hope. Anyway, guys, those are the biggest takeaways, the reaction review from episode 6 of The Walking Dead World Beyond. Let me know what you thought down in the comments below. Be sure to like the video if you're liking the video. Subscribe and click the bell so that you don't miss as we cover this and a ton of other movies and TV shows. Go check out the channel. We got a lot of stuff, as well as our sister channel, Lara Quente Ledger. I've got another show over there. If you're into tech and video games, be sure to check that one out. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching, as always, and I will see you in the next one. Peace.